Python is making his way to the cage. This guy has a fantastic reception. Everyone's camera phones are out.
Aung La Burmese Python on Sam Michal Pasternak.
It's on Michael, no time to defend yourself at all time. Touch block, back your corner.
There's going to be a lot of pressure on Aung La Aung San as he's fighting in his home territory here, and everyone is shouting out his name. The stadium is going crazy for him. There's going to be that pressure. He's going to feel it, but you know, maybe he can ride off that and put a good fight together tonight.
Pasternak is moving very well laterally as Aung La's rush is moving forward, and he connected there with a right hand.
Yeah, Michael just got caught there, and Aung La Aung San looks pretty calm and collected here. He's actually standing in the center of the cage, letting Michael wander around and change his stance, but Aung La Aung San is looking very calm and composed.
Yeah, Aung La Aung San says he draws energy from his Myanmar people, and he uses that, and it's almost like an energy burst that comes exploding out of his fists.
Well, they are all here tonight, and they are all supporting him. Let's hope all of that energy goes into the center of the cage and helps Aung La Aung San win this fight.
Pasternak's moving back and forth, he's changing positions. Aung La landed a nice little leg kick, and you gotta wonder, from that knee injury, does it impair Pasternak at all in his movement, his ability?
You do have to wonder, and I mean, if this fight gets out of the first round, maybe you'll feel a bit of wear and tear. Aung La Aung San might be aiming for that particular leg. That might be part of the game plan as well. But you know, Aung La is looking pretty calm. He's letting Michael throw those strikes, and he's just blocking them and, you know, shaking them off his shoulder. Head kick thrown there by Aung La Aung San. I thought Michael Pasternak's reach advantage might play a bit more in this jabbing exchange, but Aung La Aung San appears to be doing very well.
The crowd is getting behind their hero, Aung La Aung San, as he jumps forward to throw that big right hand. He's really not putting together the punches on this massive night here in Myanmar, but that was I like the way he's throwing these kicks and he's attacking the legs of Pasternak, Peter.
Yeah, Pasternak he wobbled a little bit on his leg there, but Pasternak just threw a barrage of four hooks, and some of them connected. No damage being shown on either of the guys' faces here. Aung La Aung San throwing in nice counters, a bit of an overhand there, ducking under Michael Pasternak's punches. You know, it could go either way at the moment, but that leg kick is going to make a difference.
Yeah, that's gonna pay some big dividends later in the fight. And Aung La is just tearing up that lead leg, and it's forcing Pasternak to switch as he lands a nice overhand right to Pasternak's chin. And again, as Pasternak jumps in, he gets caught with another right hand. That's a beautiful right hand, Peter.
Beautiful right hand, lovely counters coming in from Aung La here. Michael Pasternak is not taking the fight to the ground. Maybe he should do that now, as Aung La is actually outstriking him.
Yeah, there has been zero takedown attempts from both these fighters. But now Pasternak is starting to let go a little bit, and we're seeing a little bit of blood trickle down from Pasternak, and that's from that right hand that's been connecting beautifully.
That's got to give Aung La a little bit more confidence in this fight, knowing he's damaged his opponent. Visually being able to see that is very good when you're in the middle of that cage. About to take it to the cage, speaking of which, however, they're back in the center again. That right duck under cross seems to work very well. It's a very good weapon for Aung La. And Michael Pasternak throwing wildly, hitting air with his reply.
Aung La said he wanted to showcase those boxing skills he's been working so hard on. And Jamal Hargrove at a crazy 88 says he's got some beautiful hand combinations we haven't yet seen yet. So this is a new dimension to the Burmese Python.
But he's sitting there and he's sticking and moving, and he's looking to set those new strikes that we have not seen yet up. That big overhand right is playing a big part in this fight as well, I can definitely tell you that.
But he's not really putting together combinations. He's just timing that right hand, and that's been the most effective strike. Now Pasternak's starting to put it on him a little bit as the fight goes to the ground, but we've only got 20 seconds left, Peter.
20 seconds might not be enough to get a submission unless they are very cunning. Okay, they're back up with cage control there from Michal Pasternak, pushing his head up against the chin of Aung. It's a reasonably strong finish for Michal Pasternak for the round, but he had been totally outstruck throughout the first.
Man, Peter, I'm having a hard time hearing you in history here in Myanmar as Pasternak jumps in for the takedown, immediately goes into the clinch and presses Aung Lang Sung up against the cage, but he gets pushed off.
Very cool and composed there, Aung Lang Sung. He made sure he did exactly what he had to do to get Michal Pasternak off, throwing that big, heavy right kick there. Oh, Michal Pasternak coming back with some strikes, but they look a bit wavy, they're not direct, they're not accurate. Aung La is hunting down Michal Pasternak through that big left cross in a southpaw position now. He's hitting that leg with his left roundhouse kick to Michal Pasternak's lead leg. Michael is throwing his punches at the air, and Aung La is just being
down,
accurate.
Peter, but he goes for the takedown and gets the double leg. I like how Aung Lang Sung changed his stance and went southpaw, Peter, but now, oh, he's got his back.
Aung La led the fight, move to the cage there, and now he's going Burmese Python on Michal Pasternak. He has a rear naked choke attempt in from the side here. May not be deep at all, so he's going to have to readjust. Michael is looking a little bit exhausted. This is when the boa constrictor, the Burmese Python, can go in and cause some damage. He's got half guard right now up against the cage. Michael is looking like he's in a bad place right now. There might be some more ground and pound before we see Aung La try and dig in one of his infamous submission attempts. He's passing the guard of Michal Pasternak there. Michal Pasternak got one butterfly hook in on the left. Now he's pulled back to full guard. And, he's let Aung La stand up, jump back into guard, and do some strikes.
Back and forth battle here on the ground, but Pasternak's doing the right thing. He's staying relaxed, staying composed. He's got to be careful about the kicks, but he lands a nice shot there as he goes in. It looks like Aung Lang Song's trying to adjust, but Pasternak goes in for the double leg, got him pressed up against the cage.
Aung La gets the underhook, so it's going to make Pasternak work super hard to get that takedown. Let's see if he can. Aung La looks very composed, though. Pasternak does look the more tired of the two. Going in, Das choke, maybe? No? Okay. Pasternak's gone down to the ground. He can't stay in that position. He's trying to dive around in a wrestling style to get to the back of Aung La, but Aung La just stands back up and knees him in the head.
Pasternak's mouth is wide open, breathing heavily, and Aung Lang Sung looks like he just started the fight as he's walking through Central Park. He throws a nice little inside leg kick. Pasternak answers back with some punches and a leg kick of his own.
Aung La does look a little tired, speaking like, of Michal Pasternak's tiredness, but not to the same degree by any means. Michal Pasternak landing a couple of jabs in there in a southpaw position, but I don't think that's going to faze Aung La too much. Aung La is going to stay there and wait for the counter, quite possibly. The crowd is really getting behind Aung La Aung Sung right now. They want to see him finish this fight, and they want to see him do it in style.
You got to wonder. He throws him to the ground and ends up on top. Now Pasternak is trying to pass over into mount, but it looks like Aung La Aung Sung has the knee in there as he's pressing up against, he's pushing away on the hips.
Yeah, he's pushing away on the hips there, and he's hip escapes so that Michal Pasternak's up against the cage, but it means he can't push him any further. So Michal Pasternak now is like in a sort of half guard. There's one butterfly hook in from Aung La's left leg. Aung La being a jiu-jitsu practitioner, obviously he's gonna try and flip the situation around. It's half guard now, Michal Pasternak throwing in elbows. This is an exciting fight. This is the fight that the crowd here in Yangon wanted to see.
We got less than 1 minute to go in round two. Aung Lang Sung looks very relaxed. I think he's sucking in all that energy from this packed crowd here in Myanmar.
He is indeed. He just looked up to the clock to see how much left of round two there is. So there's now less than 40 seconds. Michal Pasternak is in the top position, but he is in half guard. Aung La Aung Sung has his left knee across the belly, so Michael can't advance. But Michael just managed to get into his full guard. Will Michael sit up? and do strikes. That's what he needs to do to get a potential TKO in the last 20 seconds, Mitch.
Pasternak looks like he's dominating this fight by a little bit of ground and pound. You gotta wonder, is this enough to start swinging the fight in his favor as we get the 10-second clapper? Aung Lan Song trying to fight from guard, keeping Pasternak nice and close so he's not able to unleash any strikes.
Be very close to each other. It's that straight right. That right cross from Aung Lan Song is landing, but Michal Pasternak comes out with three shots that landed as well. So I'm just looking into the cage here instead of the monitor. Nice leg kick from Aung Lan. This is such an exciting fight to watch. And you know, it's made all that much more exciting because the crowd is going crazy for their hometown hero.
Everything Aung Lan does, the crowd just erupts with noise. And a nice little attempt at a strike, but Aung Lan slipped just barely out of the way as Pasternak's punch flew by his face.
There you go, the body shots, mixing it up a bit. As you said, Aung Lan trying to do combinations with his boxing. Getting that leg kick in again, just missing. And Olivia Kost steps in to address an issue with one of Michal Pasternak's gloves.
I like the leg kicks, Peter. Those are doing a lot of damage, and they're landing very consecutively. If he could put together some of those low leg kicks followed by some punches, we're going to see him start to put together these combinations he's been talking about.
It would be fantastic if he could do that. I would love to see it. Okay, they're both back at very close range. Michal throwing overhand jabby crosses, and he's landing several of them as well, but Aung Lan is doing a good job of just brushing them off. Aung Lan hits the cage and rolls out back into the center of Michal. Michal looks to get that body lock on, but he's only got a seat on the hook. Falls to the ground. Aung Lan is actually in a dominant position here. He has a Muay Thai clinch on there. Michal throws that left hook and lands. They both roll back to the center of the cage.
Looks to be the fresher of the two fighters as Pasternak's mouth is wide open, his hands are down by his waist. Aung Lan's consistently pushing forward. If he would jump on him, he might be able to land some more damage here.
He might do. I mean, Michael's hands are completely down by his side. This would be a great time for Aung Lan to throw in some crosses and do some head-striking damage. Michal still having those big rabbit punches. The thing is, though, he is very heavy. He's weighing in at over 100 kilograms. Those rabbit punches will do some significant damage, so Aung Lan is doing a good job to move out of the way of them.
Good movement by Aung Lan. He looks to be the fresher of the two, nice and light, getting his range right there as he's consistently moving forward. I like that inside leg kick that he's throwing, and that right hand is an absolute trip hammer, and it's landed very effectively, and it's got to be the most significant strike of the match.
I think so. Damage-wise, Aung Lan does look to be winning. Again, I'm not a judge, but if you look at Michal Pasternak's face compared to Aung Lan Aung Sung's, I definitely give this fight to Aung Lan right now. However, it's also accumulation of strikes. Michal Pasternak just fell to the floor. He shot in for a takedown, but he didn't put any momentum behind it. Aung Lan dives on top of him with a hammer fist, and he's about to pass Michal Pasternak's guard completely. He's in sight control. He just demonstrated some great ground control there. He's got the elbow on Michael's face. Can Aung Lan put enough energy out on that mat now to finish this fight in this position, in sight control, on top of Michal Pasternak? Don't forget, though, Michal Pasternak is the Polish ADCC champion, so he does know what he's doing, but fatigue is setting in.
We got about 90 seconds left in this highly competitive middleweight fight. Back into the guard of Pasternak. Aung Lan just kind of looked up into the clock to see how much time he's got left.
That's exactly what he's doing here. He wants to know how long he's got to stay in this dominant position for and throw ground and pound. He can win this fight on decision if he hasn't, you know, already, by putting in more damage and showing more ground control in this last minute of the fight against Michal Pasternak. He's moving position here. He's looking to get to full mount. He's in half guard right now. Michal Pasternak throwing in strikes, still touching the ear of Aung Lan, so they're legal, not the back of the head. But Michal is keeping him close, which is a sign that he can't take any more strikes and doesn't want to. Michael.
Nice there as Aung La Aung Sa just passed the guard as Pasternak tried to create some a little bit of movement. Now he's got knee on belly, and he's going to finish this fight in a very dominant position in side control.
He's really, really working that side control with 15 seconds left. Olivier Costa stepping in to make sure everything's okay. A knee to the head. The damage is mounting up. Oh, my goodness. The crowd is going wild right now. I really, really... I just don't know what's going to happen if he does win.
Red corner!
Python.